Thank you so much.
A serious mister, shake his hand and twist.
Why, thank you. Thank you so much. It's really fun to play in Brooklyn because I've developed an impression of Brooklyn as being the hippest place in the universe, because my bass player Paul here lives where do you live? Greenpoint?
Greenpoint.
Yeah. Okay, so when we're out on the road and we're sort of walking around and I'll see some girl in like a cute jacket or something, like, oh, that's, I like that look. And Paul will go like, yeah, the girls have been walking around Greenpoint doing that for like the last year. So you're like, oh yeah, the little red shoes and the red bag. Yeah, I see Greenpoint girls doing that all the time.
That is so untrue, I don't know what to say.
Dude, you do. You know, there's like the tweed jacket and the sweatshirt look. You know that look for guys, like the tweed jacket and the sweatshirt? I think you all know that look because you're in Brooklyn. which apparently that look has been going on for fucking years before it hit the rest of the states.
Hey, I'm just
proud
of Brooklyn.
Being a state all of it, all in its own.
I'm proud of Brooklyn.
Oh, what a, that was such a cheap way to garner
and
some
applause.
And they
didn't go for it.
I'm going to play you a new song tonight. I've started making a record. I might be out after the first of the year if I can, you know, fucking hustle. I think I'm going to call the record King of the Jailhouse. And this is a song from it called Going Through the Motions. Something isn't right. I don't know how I know. But baby, it's despite your dog and pony show. I can hear it coming. You're only going through the motions, babe. With your engines humming. You're only going through the motions, babe. Going through the motions, babe. Feel like I'm in jail with you and Mr. Hyde. A guy who leaves a trail about a mile wide. So if it starts already, you're just going through the motions, babe. You can throw confetti, but you're just going through the motions, babe. Thank you so much.
Fragments and none of the pizza.
you. Loving you guys so much right now. It's not what you thought when you first began it. You got what you want. You can hardly stand it though, but now you know it's not. So that song was from the Magnolia soundtrack. And this is also from the Magnolia soundtrack.
Girl in me.
Let's see. God, thank you so much. So I took up boxing. I started taking boxing lessons about 6 months ago. And the first show we played at the store was like 2 weeks ago or something. I mentioned that to the audience. And then apparently it started a little firestorm of controversy on my website message board. My manager was telling me that there was a posting where someone said, you know, appeared to be very alarmed at the very idea that I would be boxing, and said, don't, you know, she needs to be aware of the dangers of boxing, you know, the broken noses and the chipped teeth or whatever. And then went on to say that it was obvious, in addition, that I was not a very robust physical specimen. And I take great offense to that, the robust physical specimen. So I've been thinking and then I've been sort of asking around, I mean, not asking around, but I tell people that I box and they say, like, oh, you know, Bob Dylan boxes, and then apparently Ricky Lee Jones boxes. And a singer-songwriter named Joe Henry, who's producing my record, he boxes also. So I'm thinking, like, you know, how about a little tour where there's, you know, singer-songwriters, but then a couple of bouts in between sets? I think that would keep things really interesting. And also to see who could finish out the night. I got, you know, Dylan's like 20 years older than me. I think I could probably take him. I'd like to introduce my fabulous band to you, please. A huge round of applause for Jebin Bruni, keyboard player, weighing in at 108 pounds, super flyweight. Bass player Paul Bryan, welterweight. Cruiserweight John Sands on drums. And Julian, Coryell, I don't know how much you weigh, but Scorpio. Yes, it's just another retarded thing I've said. Dude, I don't even know if you're a Scorpio.
I'm not. Okay.
Libra.
Aries. My brother's a Scorpio.
That doesn't count. Now yeah. I have to know. Now we have to know.
This is really
uncomfortable. Should we keep guessing? Leo. I'm running out of answers. I'm running out of possibilities. He's like, you're opening a dangerous can of worms right now.
What sign are you, Aimee?
I'm a Virgo.
Oh.
I'm the classic nitpicky critical Virgo.
That's cool.
Except I'm untidy. But I love tidiness. I love it, but I don't have it. You know, it's sad when that happens, when you love it, but you don't have it. Dude, this has gotten very, very sad all of a sudden. This song is called Stupid Thing. Thank you so much.
Till they reach China home.
much. So much. Oh my God, you guys are so tolerant. We're actually going to do a little number called 4th of July.
Disneyland's about to close.
cigarettes and red vines. Just close your eyes, cause baby, you never do know. And they'll be on the sidelines with my hands tied, watching the show. Well, it's always fun and games until it's clear you haven't got the skill in keeping the gag from going too far. So you're running around the parking lot till every lightning bug is caught, punching something holes in the lid of a jar while we wait in the car with cigarettes and red vines. Just close your eyes, cause baby, you never do know. And I'll be on the sidelines with my hands tied, watching the show. And tell me, would it kill you? Would it really spoil everything if you didn't blame yourself? Do you know what I mean? Cigarettes and red vines. Just close your eyes, cause baby, you never do know. And I'll be on the sidelines with my hands tied, watching the show. Cigarettes and red vines. Just close your eyes, cause baby, you never do know. And I'll be on the sidelines with my hands tied, watching the show. I'd like to play another song from my last record, Lost in Space. It's a song called Invisible Ink. And the thing with this song is that it's I need some help from you guys. And truly, as an audience member, I hate audience participation. You know, unless it's Bobby McFerrin. But I need you to clap at the very end, and it really is like 4 minutes from the beginning of the song, so you'll probably forget all about it. But it's because there's a really long, like long quiet part, and then it gets loud, and then it gets quiet, and then it gets loud, and then after the second loud part. But we'll I'll tell you when. I'll give you a look that you'll know how to interpret. So let's rehearse that just for a moment, if you don't mind. And again, I apologize. I hate clapping in as an audience person, but I entreat you with all that I have to join me in this endeavor. So it'll sound a little something like this. You'll do a little 2 and 4. Okay, there's like 4 fucking people clapping. Thank you. Well, that's a respectable showing. And there'll be like a little, I'll be doing like a little woo-woo, like a hoo-hoo-hoo sound over it, so you'll, okay, that's how you'll recognize it. Thank you, that was excellent. Okay, 4 minutes from now, I'll see you. Thanking you in advance.
There comes a time when you swim or sink, still I jumped in the drink, 'cause I couldn't make myself. myself clear. Maybe I wrote an invisible ink. Oh, I've tried to think how I could have made it appear, but another illustration is wasted, 'cause the results are the same. I feel like a ghost who's trying to move your hands over some Ouija board in the hopes I can spell out my name. What some take for magic at first glance is just sleight of hand, depending on what you believe. Something gets lost when you translate. It's hard to keep straight. Perspective is everything. And I know now which is which and what angle I ought to look at it from. I suppose I should be happy to be misread. Better be that than some of the other things I have become.
I'm going to play it on piano, even though I don't really play piano, but I wrote it on piano. And this is called King of the Jailhouse, and that's what my new record's going to be called, probably. It's a real little cheer-upper. Yeah. A song about bitterness, unhappiness, and dysfunction. Oh, wait a minute. That's all my songs. All right, here we go. King of the jailhouse and the queen of the road think sharing the burden will lighten the load. So they pack up their troubles in an old Cadillac. That's her in the mirror asleep in the back. Baby, there's something wrong with me. Mexico. Thank you. Which brings us to our final number. Oh, thank you. This song is called Deathly.
Now that I've met you, that you object to, never seeing each other again. Stuff. Because I
so fucking awesome.